how can you, yes, you, the viewer, prepare for Call of Duty World War II? The beta is right around the corner. Not long after that, the Call of Duty World War II game actually drops. So this is how you guys can prepare and, you know, get ahead of your friends and be better when the game actually drops. If you are new, please consider subscribing. I am a couple off. I'm like 154 subscribers, so we're 6 off 160. It'll be great if you could all smash that like button. Subscribe if you're new. I'm doing a Call of Duty World War II beta giveaway. If you don't know how to enter, it'll be in the top right of your card. You can go check that video out and enter that way. But let's get into the video. So the best way that I have personally found to prepare for Call of Duty World War II is go back onto Advanced Warfare. Now, you might be thinking, Advanced Warfare? Jetpacks? What have they got in common? Now, the studio that is developing Call of Duty World War II actually made Advanced Warfare. So they're going to have a similar sort of base game, so to speak. The guns will be reacting similar, the recoil will be similar on certain weapons, the kill streaks will be as similar as possible to what you have in Advanced Warfare. Obviously it's not going to be exactly the same because they're two different time zones and time eras and time periods, whatever. But you got the M1 Grand, we know that's confirmed in Call of Duty World War II. It's in Advanced Warfare, so why not hop on Advanced Warfare and use it? Now, I did try and find a game of, like, just normal pubs on classic mode, but no one plays that at all. I was searching for 15, 20 minutes, couldn't find a game on that. Went on to Team Deathmatch, and it just kept chucking me into games that had already been sort of all the way done. There was, like, 80 kills, 70 kills, like that. And I don't want to bring you guys content where it's almost done. I don't want to do that. I want to bring you guys a full, juicy game, so apologies for that. So it's just a bit of an infected game, but the M1 Grand is a great way to start because we know it's confirmed in Call of Duty World War II. The same development studio makes it, so the guns will react really similarly. Unfortunately, I did use a jetpack, but you guys cannot and sort of adjust to the boots on the ground situation. And if you have any other older Call of Duties, MW3 would be a great start. Sledgehammer helped develop that game as well, so just consider it. It might help, it will probably help a big deal, and like I said earlier on, I'm doing a beta giveaway. To enter that, it will be in the top right of your card, but I hope you all enjoyed the rest of the video. This is Lukey, and I am out. Peace until about 2 seconds. Alright guys, I am back, and I just couldn't find a game for some reason. I don't know why, I just know games were about, but from the games that were almost finished that I did play, I can definitely tell you guys this gun sucks. Now, obviously, you try looking in the classic playlist on Advanced Warfare, which is basically the boots on the ground playlist without the jetpacks, and you can't find a game. That's problem number one. Problem number two, okay? Trying to kill someone with this weapon is next to impossible at close range. Now, you might be thinking, all right, okay, just maybe whack rapid fire on it, but it's only got eight bullets in a clip. So you think, oh, if you're gonna put rapid fire on it, you're gonna have to, you know, put maybe a bit of that extended mag on. But no, you can't. There's no extended mag on this game. In my opinion, this gun is just absolutely pants. I would highly recommend not using it because of how bad it is. In a public, it's easy what I'm doing now, but in a public match it's just not feasible at all. Now, some of you might be really good with it, some of you might not be so good with it, like me. I'm absolutely terrible with it, but I mean, some other people might be actually pretty decent with it. And if you don't hit if you miss the first two shots, you're gonna die. It's just as simple as that. You will die if you don't hit your first shots. Now, I don't think they know how to quite get up here, but I'm gonna run out of bullets before I get a DNA, so I'm gonna have to jump down. But in my opinion, this gun is just awful. Absolutely awful. Like, you can't do anything with it. It's too bad. And I mean, it could be a really good gun. I know it's sort of the era, but there's no boots on the ground on this Call of Duty, so everything's a lot harder to shoot. Everything in general really is just a lot harder to do and accomplish. So I mean, if you've got Advanced Warfare, you're kind of screwed. Because I'm almost fell off there, because it's just too difficult to use, too hard. And I would personally say it's not worth the hassle, like, just using it, you know. I would just personally say don't even try it. But I don't know, we're trying to get into the spirit of Call of Duty World War 2, but it's just impossible with a fucking gun that bad. But anyway, I hope you all enjoyed. I know it's a bit of a letdown because it's not an actual gameplay, but if you did enjoy, please like, comment, and subscribe. This is Lukey, and I'm out. Peace.